The purpose of this video lecture is to cover the sexual response in males. So just to remind you, these are the lectures that you've had so far, the functional anatomy of the male reproductive system. We've discussed the hormone regulation of the male reproductive system. We've discussed sperm and their development, and now we're on the last lecture for the male reproductive system, the sexual response in males. So the sexual response in males is controlled by the autonomic nervous system. It includes the spinal reflexes, and there are three different phases that are involved in the sexual response. There's the erection phase, which is followed by the emission phase, which is then followed by ejaculation. The erection phase is regulated by the parasympathetic nervous system, whereas the emission phase is regulated by the sympathetic nervous system as well as the ejaculation phase. What we're going to be doing is going through each of these phases. So we're going to begin with the erection phase. So there are two different stimuli that lead to an erection. So the stimuli here are listed at the top. Mechanical stimulation of receptors in the penis, as well as increased activity in descending neural pathways from the brain. So these are the stimuli. These stimuli are going to act on inner neurons of the spinal cord. What the spinal cord does then is it's going to increase activity in the parasympathetic neurons to the penis. And so once again, since the parasympathetic activity increases, sympathetic activity decreases. Parasympathetic neurons to the penis can relax the arterioles. They're going to relax the smooth muscle of the arterioles that supply blood to the erectile tissue of the penis. So what that's going to do is that's going to cause vasodilation of the arterioles that are supplying blood to this erectile tissue. So if you vasodilate, we know that that's going to increase the blood flow to this erectile tissue. Therefore, the blood volume and the blood pressure are going to go up. So that's going to lead to an erection. Now, increased blood volume and blood pressure is also going to compress the veins in this erectile tissue. So if you compress the veins, will you be able to remove the blood from this tissue? Or is the blood going to accumulate in this tissue? So the blood is actually going to end up accumulating in this erectile tissue. So compression of the veins causes accumulation of the blood in the erectile tissue. And so because you accumulate the blood, there's less blood leaving the erectile tissue. And this starts a positive feedback loop. That's what causes erection. Now, there's one other thing that I want to mention about the parasympathetic neurons and their stimulation of the penis. We said that the parasympathetic nervous system is going to relax the smooth muscle of the arterioles that supply this erectile tissue. The parasympathetic nervous system is also going to cause the release of nitric oxide. And because you have this release of nitric oxide, this is also abbreviated NO. This is a potent vasodilator. So you have yet one more mechanism by which the arterioles supplying blood to the erectile tissue vasodilate. So not only is it directly parasympathetic stimulation, but it's also the release of nitric oxide that will cause this. So what I would like you to do is to read about impotence and erectile dysfunction. And one of those treatments is Viagra. There's another treatment called Cialis that you may have heard about on television as well. What these various treatments do is they increase blood flow to the erectile tissue, and they have different mechanisms by doing so. So I'd like you to think about how these drugs may increase blood flow to the erectile tissue. The next phase then is the emission phase. As the response to mechanical stimulation from erection continues, okay, your neural activity is actually going to shift from parasympathetic to a sympathetic control. So now we have the sympathetic nervous system taking over. The sympathetic nervous system is going to cause contractions of the epididymis, the vas deferens, and the ejaculatory duct. So what this means then is that we're moving sperm. Okay, we're going to move the sperm. So the sperm's going to be leaving the seminiferous tubules, and it's going to be traveling into the urethra. Now, the sympathetic nervous system also causes secretions from the seminal vesicles and the prostate. So think back to the previous lecture about what those secretions are from these two locations. So the end result of emission is you're moving the sperm, or semen rather. Semen is a combination of sperm plus the fluid. You're moving the semen into the urethra. That's what emission does. It's the movement of semen into the urethra using the sympathetic nervous system, which causes contractions of the epididymis, the vas deferens, and the ejaculatory duct, and also causes secretion from the seminal vesicles and the prostate. This phase then is followed by ejaculation. The mechanical stimulation is still occurring, and this is still mediated by the sympathetic nervous system. Remember, with emission, the result of emission was moving the semen into the urethra. Once that happens, this is going to stimulate ejaculation. Okay, and what we mean by stimulating ejaculation is that it stimulates contractions of the smooth muscle in the urethra and the skeletal muscle at the base of the penis. This also stimulates closure of the urethral sphincter so that you do not have urine and semen mixing. You don't have that happening because there's the closure of the urethral sphincter. So the end result then of ejaculation is to move the semen from the urethra to the outside of the body. One thing I want you to think about. So we said the sympathetic nervous system here is stimulating closure of the urethral sphincter. I want you to go back and look at micturition, which is urination, right? And I want you to look at what causes micturition. I want you to compare that to ejaculation, and I want you to think about how, or another reason, why there is no urine mixed with semen. So that concludes this part of the video.